wondrous tale of chivalry for you we now unfold. Of days when dragons ruled the land and all the knights were bold. And a handsome prince daring deeds must do his princess for to win. We hope you will enjoy this tale. Now let our play begin.
Majesties, King Nordford and Beatrice of the House B, first of her name, the currently unburnt Queen of the Dorandals.
Oh,
and
get on with it, we haven't got all day.
In brief, Queen B.
What about my ovation? Well, is that it?
Is that what, ma'am?
My ovation.
To put it briefly, not to beat around the bush or to mince words, yes.
Well, it's not good enough.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there.
It's not, though, is it?
No.
Do you think it's good enough?
No.
No, that's right. You could do a lot better for Queen Bee, couldn't you?
Yes.
See, this is a pantomime. And in a pantomime, we have a thing called audience participation, and that's you. We need your involvement, you see, and that means an ovation. You know how to ovate, don't you? Madam, you know how to ovate, don't you? Don't you? Yes, you do, you see, she's nodding her head. Now, if she knows how to ovate, so can the rest of you. So, we're going to have a little try at this. An ovation begins with a bit of clapping, so can we have some clapping? To that, a bit of shouting and some whooping. Oh. Very good. How about some foot stamping? Foot stamping going on there. Now, can anybody whistle? Oh, that's a good whistle. Right, so now we want to bring it all together. So we'll have a little practice. After three, one, two, three. Now that's what I call an ovation. Right, I'm going to go off, and then I'll come back on, and then we'll hear your tumultuous applause. Now remember, we want to hear that every time I come on. Right, so now, where was I? Oh yes, My husband and I... Where is he? Nod? Nod! I bet he's fallen asleep again. Go and wake him up, Portby.
I don't think that's my job, ma'am.
Oh, really? Well, whose job is it, then?
The underfootman of the bed, ma'am.
Would you like to be the underfootman of the bed? I can soon arrange that.
Very well. I shall go.
I don't know why he's always falling asleep. Anybody think he was bored? I mean, I've tried to keep myself alluring. I've had everything lifted, as you can see. The only thing that keeps him awake is watching that Strictly Come Jousting.
Oh, yes.
He's jaded, that's what he is. There you are. Always falling asleep on the throne.
Should have done Sleeping Beauty.
Thank you, that'll be enough of that. A bit of respect for your reigning monarch. Right, tip him off. You did it again, didn't you?
No.
Oh, yes, you did. And today of all days, I'm ashamed of you. You do know what today is, don't you?
No.
Today is the day your son's future bride arrives in the kingdom. The Princess Hyacinth of Flordovia, the future queen of this land. When I'm gone, of course.
Are you going, then?
No, I'm not. Not yet, sunshine, so you can wipe that sickly grin off your face. Right, you lot, I want you all on your best behaviour. For when the princess comes, I don't want you doing what you normally do. No sliding down the banisters.
Aww.
No singing rude songs about the cook.
Aww.
Or me.
Aww.
And there is to be no mention of Midsummer Night's Eve and the dragon. Yeah. Don't the poor little thing frightened to death. And you, can't you stay awake?
No.
I said nobody is to mention the dragon.
Ah, yes. It will soon be Midsummer's Eve. I wonder who the dragon will choose this year. He always chooses the fairest maiden in the land.
Ah, yes. Every year I wait to see if my call will come, and I'll end up as the dragon's dinner.
Well, that would just give him indigestion.
Who said that?
We won't know who's been chosen until Baron Blackheart arrives.
I don't understand why the dragon will only talk to Baron Blackheart.
It has always been so, although... I thought it would be better if the dragon were to communicate directly with their majesties.
Hey, what do you mean? We don't want to go to the Badlands and talk to the dragon, do we not?
No.
No, we don't. So don't be a silly little chamberlain, Hortby. The Baron lives in the Badlands, so he doesn't mind. I only hope he doesn't bring those two awful sisters of his with him, Bessie and Bertha. Gadzooks, they're man mad. They're always on the lookout for a husband. Do you know that they've even made advances to our own dear Prince George?
Well, they've never made any advancements towards... me.
No. Well, they're not that desperate, are they? You've got again, haven't you?
No.
Oh, yes, you have. We all saw you. You all saw him, didn't you?
Yeah.
I'm going to need your help. Every time you see him fall asleep, I want you to call out, "Wakey, wakey!" So... we'll have a practice after three. One, two, three.
Wakey, wakey!
Nope, that's no good. He's still asleep. You'll have to do it much louder than that. One, two, three.
Wakey, wakey!
Good. Now remember that every time he falls asleep.
Where is Prince George anyway?
Oh, he couldn't wait to see the princess. He had to go to the battlements to catch the first glimpse of her.
Oh,
I know. Romantic, isn't it? You used to be just like that, didn't you, Nod?
No.
No. Sometimes I think...
She's coming! She's nearly here!
Oh, right. Calm down, George. Calm down. Do I look all right? Is my lipstick smudged? No? Oh, good. What does she look like? Oh, never mind. Never mind. We shall find out, won't we? Right. You stay awake. Positions, everyone.
Princess Hyacinth of Flordovia, daughter of King Lupin,
yes,
and Queen...
Yes, that'll do. Thank you very much. How nice to meet you, my dear. May I present King Nodford and my son and your future husband, Prince George. Oh, look at that nod. Doesn't it remind you of us?
No.
I am very pleased to meet you all. And may I present to you my lady-in-waiting, the Lady Violet.
Oh.
You are even even more beautiful than your portrait.
And you're more handsome than yours.
I think we'd better give them some time on their own, don't you? Come on, everybody, let's leave them alone for a little while.
So glad you're here at last.
Yes, it was a very long journey, but I feel at home already. And you described it all so well in your letters, especially your parents.
Well, your letters never described how beautiful you are.
Stop, Sir Pete. I'm terribly sorry about this. Right, now, 1, 2, 3!
Wakey, wakey!
Do carry on. Come on, you. You've shown me up something rotten you up. Come on. I know.
That's Princess Hyacinth, is it? Very pretty. Very pretty indeed.
I thought she was fat, didn't you, Bertha?
I certainly did.
Get off me, you
know. Oh, that's not good. Oh, you two are only saying that because she's going to marry Prince George. That's... And you both fancy her.
That's not it at all, is it, Bessie?
Certainly not. Oh, I could scratch her little boss eyes out.
I wouldn't mind marrying her myself.
You?
And what's so funny about that?
Oh, well, every year you go and get the prettiest maiden in the land, supposedly, for the dragon.
And every year you give her the choice of marrying you, being fed to the dragon, or working in our windfall factory.
So?
Well, you're still single, and we've got the biggest windfall factory in Christendom.
Well, it saves us paying wages, doesn't it? Anyway, she's a princess. She can't work in a factory. And therefore, she will have to marry me.
She might choose to go to the dragon instead.
Look, my father and his father before him have all done the same thing. And not one maiden has chosen to be eaten by a dragon. And neither will she. Anyway, as a princess, she's been taught to recognise quality when she sees it.
Well, that's why she won't marry you.
Anyway, Prince George wouldn't let his princess go to the dragon.
Well, he'll have to, won't he? Otherwise he knows what will happen. The dragon will fly out of his cave and burn all the crops, all the houses, and all the people to cinders.
The dragon never leaves his cave.
That's right. In fact, if he weren't in there roaring and making all that smoke, we wouldn't even know he was there, would we?
Yes, well, they don't know that, do they, Pudding?
Ow!
And as long as you don't tell them, we get a new worker for free every year.
Well, I hope it works again this year, and then I can marry George.
You don't stand a chance. It's me he's always fancied.
Fancied you? I remember when he was little, he hit you on the head with his mates.
That was just playful affection. Anyway, he pushed you in the moat.
He gave me those water wings first, didn't he?
Made of iron.
But he was only little, he didn't understand.
Oh, yes, he did, frog face, so call me that pig.
Sisters, please, cease your little game.
I'll bust your ugly face and I'm going to pull your hair out.
Thank you so much, please. The sisters are full of affection for them. Oh, you see, they're full of playfulness, aren't they? Well, don't keep us in suspense. Who's it going to be this year? Has my call come at last?
Excuse me, ma'am. This must be done in the formal manner. It being the traditional 3 days before Midsummer's Eve, it is my duty to name she who appears on the parchment. She who has been chosen by the dragon this year to leave us all on Midsummer's Eve, to be chained outside his cave, and to save us all from his fiery breath. And the nominees this year are...
Come out!
Tess Anville, the blacksmith's daughter.
Ooh. Yeah.
Gertie Whoppers, the milkmaid. And Princess Hyacinth. Oh, this is very exciting. I'm very nervous indeed. And she who has been chosen this year is... Princess Hyacinth.
Oh, that's a shock.
Let me see that. This has been changed.
Excuse me, sir. The name on the paper is correct, whether it is right or wrong.
You know, Prince George, you're absolutely right. I mean, what does it matter if all the crops are burnt, all the houses are flattened, and all the people are barbecued? I mean, someone's got to stand up to this dragon. Isn't that right, Your Majesty?
No.
Oh, be quiet, you silly sausage. We can't let Princess Hyacinth go to the dragon, can we, boys and girls?
No!
I mean, we can't.
No, I can't let you do it. I'll go. Perhaps the dragon won't eat me after all.
Quite right, my dear. I mean, it's worth a try, isn't it, sisters?
Oh, yes, it's worth a try.
No, this has been happening for hundreds of years and no one's ever returned. I shall come with you and I'll fight the dragon.
Hooray!
It's no good, George. We don't even have an army and you can't fight a dragon all by yourself.
We'll see about that.
Cowardly lot.
How could you let him go off on his own? Right, I want volunteers to form an army. You, and you.
Me.
And what about you, Baron Blackheart?
Well, you know, I would be with you, but I've got this bone in my leg, you know, otherwise I'd be right there with you. Yes, I would. Oh, yes, I would.
Right, I want all able-bodied men back here by tea time for weapons training. Bring your own weapons. And I know I said able-bodied men, Hortby, but I want you here as well.
As an officer, ma'am?
Certainly not.
Well, who's going to drill them?
Their commander-in-chief, of course.
Is that you, sir?
No.
No, it isn't. It's me, you idiot. Right, go on then, off you go, but be back here by tea time. Now, where did I put that arm? What fools they are! Oh, yes, they are! Oh, yes, they are! Yes, they will. I mean, they fell for my plan, so they are absolutely fools. The princess will have to marry me, and then... Oh, things are going so well, sisters.
And then, after that, Prince George will have to marry me to escape his mother.
He's going to marry me to escape you.
Oh, no, he won't.
Oh, please, sisters, let's not fight.
No.
Not when things are going so well.
Oh, yes, it is. Oh, yes, it is.
Oh,
yes, it is.
Oh,
yes, it is.
Oh,
yes.
Princess Hyacinth. Is that clearly understood?
Oh, don't beat about the bush. Just give me a straight answer.
No.
I must know. Is it her or me?
It's her.
Best out of three?
Oh, give me strength.
Ow.
Bessie, how's it going?
Look, I love everything about you. I've drawn little pictures of you and put them all on my bedroom wall. They're really good.
Excuse me, sir. Am I interrupting something?
Yes!
I'm afraid I have very urgent state business to discuss with His Highness.
Ah! All right then. Well, in that case, Georgie Porgie, I shall go off and make myself beautiful for you.
That should give us plenty of time.
Thanks, Hawkby. Saved again.
And whereas, Your Highness, the lady in question does rather remind me of a bull terrier with a bone.
Quite. Now, Hawkby, can I count on you to assist me in my hour of need?
Well, that depends, sir, on whether the assistance required is administrative, financial, or military. If it's administrative, I am your servant. If it's financial, I'm broke. And if it's military, I'm off.
Hawkby, come back. Surely you can't bear the thought of that sweet girl being eaten.
I try not to think about it, sir.
Hawkby, I appeal to your sense of chivalry.
I'm happy to say, sir, that I have none. Commoners, sir, have very little loyalty.
What are you talking about?
Well, if I were to become Sir Hawkby, I just know I'd be full of chivalry and loyalty to the crown.
Never miss a trick, dear Hawkby.
Not if I can help it, sir.
Very well, but I shall only dub you knight after we've saved the Princess Hyacinth.
Done.
Now I've been thinking, Hawkby. The dragon's main weapon is his fiery breath. So, if we can put that out, I think we might stand a chance.
And how do you intend to do that?
With the stirrup pump. We'll take it with us, and I'll do the squirting while you do the,
The pumping? Yes, I see. The things I'll do for advancement.
Come on then, Hawkby, let's go practice in the courtyard.
So you see, it's the only way. But Fairy Meddle, Your Highness, she always makes such a mess of everything. Well, I'm afraid she's our only hope. They don't have their own fairy here, so we'll have to use ours.
But do you remember what happened last time she tried to help? Your Aunt Thistle is still a toad.
Yes, but Fairy Muddle is trying very hard to reverse the spell. I mean, she did put Uncle Bramble's head back on the right way eventually, didn't she?
I know, I just don't think we should involve her.
Do you want me to be eaten by the dragon?
Oh, no, of course not. It's just... Oh, very well. Do you remember how to summon her?
I think so. Elfin Mist and Fuddle Puddle, we summon thee, Fairy Muddle. Oh, dear, do you suppose I got it wrong?
No, I'm pretty sure that was right, but she is very far away. Let us both try.
Elfin Mist and Fuddle Puddle, we summon thee, Fairy Muddle.
Oh, she obviously still can't hear us.
Will you help us?
Yes.
Great enthusiasm. That's sure to be loud. Okay, so every time we get to the end of the rhyme, can we all shout Fairy Muddle as loudly as we possibly can?
Yes.
Let's try. Elfin Mist and Fuddle Puddle, we summon thee, Fairy Muddle!
Way. But I am trying!
Yes, Hush, Violet! So do you think you can help us or not?
Well, that all depends on whether he's a blue dragon or a green dragon.
Well, is that important?
Oh, yes, blue dragons are by far the worst. Or is it green? Anyway, it's most important that we know what colour it is.
Well, I'll ask George. He's sure to know.
And in the meantime, I shall magic my spellbook here. Oh. Right! Liver of bat, eye of rook, send to me my book of spells! Oh dear! I don't think that can be right.
Now, do you see what I mean? Well, perhaps you'd do better after you've had a little rest.
Yes, I do feel a little tired.
Well, come along, I'll take you to my apartment.
Prince George and Hawtby have a plot, and Fairy Muggle too. They aim to fight the dragon fierce with spells and derring do. But dear Queen Bee has another plan that's less serene and calm. She aims to do the dragon in with grievous bodily harm.
So first of all, we thrust, and then we twist, and we twist, and we twist, until all of his outsides are on the outside, laying on the floor. Then come back here, you witch.
I'm dead.
You leave the royal presence.
Can we use some little sticks?
Little sticks.
Yeah, or we can call him Rude Knave. Yes, then they would chase us, and we could capture him when he runs out of breath.
Gauls, give me strength. What we need here is some drill to instill some discipline. That's what we need. Discipline. Aha, Noddy! Come to join the troops, have you?
No.
No. I didn't think so. Thank you for your support, dear. Right. So, we're going to... We'll start off with something simple. We will, first of all, execute a right turn. So, at the command, right! Tack! Face front. We'll do something simpler. I want you all to raise your right hand.
No, your right hand.
This is my right hand.
No, you don't understand. Come out here. Come on, look. See, now. Watch. Right. Now do you see? Wait a minute, that can't be right. Now, do you see?
Yes, you've got the wrong hand up.
No, I haven't. You've got the wrong hand up.
You said the right hand.
Yes.
Well, this is the hand that I write with.
I give it, honestly. Go on. Yeah. Right. What we're going to do now is we're going to practice charging the dragon.
How much?
I beg your pardon?
How much are we going to charge him?
Why don't we do the joke?
I hadn't noticed.
I'll do it so I get another beep out of you, don't you? Right, bring on the enemy, Hawtby. No sniggering in the ranks. This is the enemy, this is the dragon. We're going to practice charging. I need a volunteer. You'll do. Don't you? Come on. Hawtby, come over here. Excellent. So when I give the command, I
I want you to charge the dragon with all of your might. Ready? One, two, three, charge! Don't encourage him. Well, it was accurate. I think it lacked a little ferocity, though, don't you think? Look, I'll tell you what, we'll have another go, and this time, you shout charge. It'll make you feel more fierce. At the command, charge!
Charge.
Best. Come on, thank you. We'll try one more time, and this time we'll all shout out charge, and that includes you as well. So we'll have a practice of that. Ready? One, two, three,
charge!
Oh, it's working. Look, he's getting his rats up. Right, once more. One, two, three,
charge!
Not bad. Right, come back here. We'll try something else now. We'll try a bit of marching. We'd better get rid of these pipes first, though, I think. Back to the armour. Right, when you're ready, form up. And the command. Right, ten, three, march. Lift, 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 right, lift. You've got to keep in time.
We should have a band.
Yeah!
Band. That's a good idea, isn't it?
Well, I'm not just a pretty face.
You're not even a pretty face. Hawkey, bring on some instruments. Right, have a look at these. Can any of you play any of these?
No.
Not a musician amongst them. Volunteers for a band, that's what we need. Go and get me some volunteers, quickly. Small ones if you can find them. Wave, shall we? Do you want to give us a shake of your tambourine? Oh. Bam! You're looking a very commanding young man. Who are you?
Joseph.
Joseph. Ah, Joseph. We know you, I think, don't we?
Yes.
I've seen from yesterday. Very popular. People want to come and see you over and over again. Right, Joseph, give us a bang on your drum. Ooh. Very good. So what we have asked you to do, the army here, we have a marching song, see, and we have some music that goes with that. So we're going to play the music, and we want you to play along to it. So we'll have a practice for a start. I'll get Sir Pete to play it through once. You can all join in with this, because you'll know the music, and you'll know the song that we use. So Sir Pete, can we have our marching song, please? So you got the drift. Get the idea, yeah? Good. Right, so now we'll do it for real, Sir Pete. Off we go then. here in the Redlands. You know, we've got lots of sweets to give them the kiddies. Got the biggest bag. Right, at the command then. Quick march. Left, 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 right, left. See you all later. I agreed to meet them here early to spy out the land. You know, I think I've outdone myself tonight. I feel sorry for Princess Hyacinth. She's gonna take one look at me and just be swept off her feet. Don't you think I look particularly handsome?
No!
Oh, yes, I do!
Oh,
yes, I do! I don't know why I'm arguing with you people who've come here from the kingdom of Primarnia, I think. Oh, who's this? Oh. Sister, you look breathtaking. I'm sure everyone here would like you to give them a twirl, wouldn't you?
Yeah!
Well, you asked for it. There you go. It's quite a sight.
Oh, thank you, brother dear. I'm going to show that Princess Hyacinth a thing or two. Prince George won't be able to resist me.
That is until he sees. Me! Oh, thank you so much. I'm sure to be the belle of the ball.
Well, you're certainly the right shape.
Eat your heart out, Kate Middleton.
Sisters, please, let's not fight tonight.
Well, I don't mind tonight if I don't get George, so you can have him if you want.
Why? What's wrong with him?
Nothing. It's just that I've decided I rather like Hawkby now.
Hawkby? I see what you mean. He wouldn't be a bad choice.
Yeah. Well, that's it then. Whoever doesn't get George can have Orby, right?
Right. That's fixed up, brother. Now, what about you, brother dear?
Oh, don't worry about me. I mean, with things going so well, the princess is just going to be swept off her feet. In fact, I've learned a few new dance moves to impress her.
Come on, then. Show
us, show us.
Let's have ya. Come on, everyone.
Gentlemen, please take your partners for the Midsummer Minuet.
How rude!
How very rude indeed.
Stop it, Sophie. Thank you very much. Yes. I mean, how can we enjoy ourselves when the princess is to go to the dragon? I mean, we haven't known her very long, but we've all come to love her, haven't we?
Yes.
Yeah.
Dear friends,
I have a feeling that all is not lost. With such great people around me, all willing to help, I just know we can defeat that dragon.
Quite right, my dear. The militia to the rescue, eh, Nod? Nod!
Wake the Wakey!
More!
Wakey Wakey!
Now, you stay awake, you.
Were we talking about killing the dragon?
Oh, yes. Yes,
because
we were.
Hoppy and I have got a few tricks up our sleeves, and I've sharpened my trusty sword.
There, you see? If I'm not sad, then neither should you be. Now, we still have some time before I have to go. So let's just enjoy ourselves.
Quite right, my dear. On with the cabaret, Hoppy. What have we got this year? I hope it's better than last year. Let's have a look. Oh, the Jolly Juggling Jester. He sounds all right. We'll try him first.
My lords and ladies, for your delight and entertainment, the Jolly Juggling Jester.
Jolly Juggling Jester. I've seen jollier things hanging from our gibbet. Right, what's next? The bouncing bakers of Britain again, Hoppy.
I received a special request for their return visit.
Stupid idiot requested the bouncing bakers of Britain.
England!
Noddy, I don't believe it. Last year I found them pathetic and stupid and boring and irritating, didn't you?
No.
Typical.
My lords and ladies, for your delight and entertainment, the Bouncing Bakers of Britain.
He's got the rest. Sit down, Lord, you're showing me up.
No.
Sit down. Sir Peter, switch off the music.
No!
I told you, switch the music off.
No!
State with confidence that no one has quite seen an act like this one before.
Well, nobody had ever seen an act like the last one. That's nothing to go by, is it?
My lords and ladies, for the final time, for your delight and entertainment, Happy Jack and his singing chicken.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
Who said that?
It's me! I'm in the dug!
In the dug? Oh, in the bag! I see, right! Well, if it isn't my old friend, the singing chicken! And what are you going to sing for us tonight?
I'm too shy to sing in front of all these tittle!
Oh, no, come along, I'm sure they're all dying to hear you, aren't you?
Yes!
They are, you see! So what's it going to be?
Green sleeves.
Wow. Well, perhaps Sir Peter would provide some music. Now, whilst winking, a goblet of wine.
I'm sorry, but he did come highly recommended.
Oh, excuse me. Oh, the princess has a lovely voice. I'm sure she could be persuaded to sing for us.
Really? That would be lovely, wouldn't it not?
No.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that.
I'm not really sure.
Better. Oh, please, I'll help you.
Thank you.
Outside the cave this morning. He'll have eaten it and he'll sleep until noon. Anyway, I'll have this done in just a tick and then we can be away.
You hope?
Now, my dear, it doesn't have to be this way. You know I'm not without influence in these parts, especially with dragons.
Do you mean you can save me?
Well, there are a few things I might be able to do to you, for you.
I'll do anything.
How's it going?
Well, on that note, I'm sure if you were to agree to be my bride, then I might be able to persuade the dragon to spare you.
Never!
Keep your voice down. Anyway, I thought you said you'd do anything.
No!
You're very handsome.
No!
I've got an enormous castle.
No!
Bessie and Bertha could be bridesmaids!
No!
It's Billy known, you know!
Right, all right. I'll give you one last chance. Do you want to be my bride?
Okay. Fine.
There is another alternative.
What's that?
Well, you see, I run Gossamer Gowns. It's It's like M&S, only smaller and more medieval. Basically, we specialise in wimpoles. And we are always on the lookout for bright young things who are willing to work for no wages in return for certain perks. Perks like not being eaten by dragons. It's a very successful business, you know. 100% successful, you might say.
Do you mean to tell me that every maiden who has ever been taken to be eaten by the dragon now works for you?
Exactly. And my father before me, and his father before him.
And you expect me to work in a factory with lots of ordinary people?
Yes, my dear, you've got the drift of it.
Princesses wear crowns, lose gloss slippers, and marry princes. They do not, I repeat, not work in the red trade!
Wow! Haven't you persuaded her yet?
He never will!
It can be shop steward.
Princesses do not become shop stewards!
Oh, you're the most useless brother there ever was!
Now what are we gonna do?
But we can't let the dragon actually eat her, can we?
Why not?
Well, we just can't, can we? Oh, come on, help me untie her. I'm very sorry.
Oh, that nutty slack, it does clog up your tubes a bit. Just a maiden, oh, that's all right. Oh, no. Don't tell me they've started this business again. Look, I'd just like to say, here and now, that my family have never eaten maidens. Thank you. Come to think, we haven't eaten anyone else come to that. Mind you, there are some dragons who aren't so fussy, but they're usually blue, you see. We green dragons, we only eat coal, so it's all right. Screaming! I've got a spitting headache, it's not fair.
Are you going to eat me?
Oh, I most certainly am not. I don't know where you made me get these ideas from.
What are you going to do with me then?
Well, firstly, I'm going to sing a song. just to clear the soot out of my tubes a little bit. So Peter, if you could,
Princess, you understand now. Sometimes I can be a little mad. But don't you know that no one alone can always be an angel when things go wrong, things so bad. But I'm the soul of the tensions of the world. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. Princess, you know I'm so carefree. With a joy that's hard to hide. And sometimes it seems all I have to do is worry. And you're back to see my other side. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. If I seem as if I want you to know, I'll never mean to take it out of you. I don't. Life has its problems, and I have my share. But that's one thing I never mean to do. Oh, I love you. Princess, don't you know I'm just a dragon? I have thoughts like any other one. Sometimes I find myself alone, regretting some terribly simple thing I've done. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are pure. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. Misunderstood. Time is the soul whose intentions are good.
down the stairs. Oh, I dropped the bottom of my glass.
To sort out my toes a little bit. Now, I think this calls for a nice cup of tea.
Yeah.
I suggest you do the same.
Where?
Well, in my cave, of course.
As you can see, I'm a little tied up at the moment.
Well, yeah, I see.
I'm tired. Yeah, so you're right. Now, you come with me, but you got to stay close, you see. Because my cave is lovely, very large, and there are lots and lots of tunnels. Do you prefer Ceylante or PG Tips?
Oh, anything. I could certainly do with a cup. I've had a terrible time.
Oh, there. Now you tell me all about it.
You know that awful Baron Blackheart?
Oh, yeah.
Why already?
I don't know what's the matter with you. You're usually a cowardly wimp.
Well, look, she's gone.
Oh.
Well, of course she's gone. What else did you expect?
Oh, well, we tried our best. Let's go.
No, not yet. I need to know if she's alive or not. Oh, we're going to have to go into the cave. Bessie, Bertha, come back here.
There's nothing we can do. It's too late. The dragon will have eaten her.
We don't know that for sure, do we?
Yeah. I've got a funny feeling.
Find
I'm sure we're being watched. I think we should hide.
Yeah, I'm feeling a little bit creepy too. Let's go.
I thought you wanted to go in the cave.
Oh, yes, well, I will, but we can do it tomorrow, can't we?
Yeah, tomorrow's fine.
This is the place. Hortby? Oh, come on, Hortby. What are you waiting for?
Caution, sir.
Well, it's your endless displays of caution that have made us so late. Come on, look. There's the cave. Ready? Charge!
Just a minute, sir. Shouldn't we think about this?
Well, what is there to think about? My princess is in there.
Yes.
With the dragon.
That's what we should think about.
Very well then, Mr. Hortby. You can stay here. Or you could charge in there with me. Sir Hortby.
A moment to recap, sir. Your princess is in that cave.
Yes.
With a fire-breathing dragon.
Yes.
I think I'll stay here.
Well, what if you were Lord Hortby?
An hereditary title?
Very well. Ready?
Fairy Muddle, where are you? Oh, please say she hasn't got herself lost again. Fairy Muddle, where are you?
I'm here somewhere, dear. I just can't seem to materialise. Hang on a minute. Thing. Oh, it's not
Dragons red and yellow, take care. Dragons purple, not too bad. And dragons green, you add 2 bats' livers and a pinch of lizard. So now we know.
Well, that doesn't sound quite right. It didn't rhyme.
Well, it seemed to rhyme perfectly to me.
Oh, Fairy Muddle, look, there's a page missing. Page 20, page 22.
Oh, what a silly sausage I am. Shrimp must have eaten it one. When he was hungry, I sometimes forget to feed him, you know.
Yes.
Never mind.
So I noticed. Well, what can we do now?
Well, I wish we'd just have to confront the dragon, dear.
But what if it tries to eat us?
Well, I'll just have to turn into a toad. You don't get much trouble with fire-breathing toads. Come along, dear.
Volunteer. Who's it going to be? Well, sir, come on, I know you'll all be falling over yourselves towards a volunteer. I tell you what we'll do. Everyone who wishes to risk their life for the princess, take 1 pace forward. Well, nobody volunteers. Somebody must want to volunteer, surely. What about you?
I don't like to stay.
All right. What about you, then?
Well, my mum's expecting me home for tea.
And you?
I'm his brother.
You wouldn't mind, would you, Nod?
No.
No, good. Quick, time up. Right. We shall all hide. And when the dragon comes out of his cave, and preferably before he eats Nod, we'll all charge like we practiced.
Oh, what if we're too late?
Well, if we're too late, we'll tie somebody else up and we'll try again. You don't mind, do you, Nod?
No.
No, good. Right, let's hide.
Dragon hunting they've all gone with spells and plots and spears. But we all know that dragons green are gentle little dears. Making such a fuss, it's Baron, Bess and Bertha with a great big blunderbuss.
Said it was the perfect thing for killing dragons.
What's it called?
A blunderbuss.
But don't point it at me!
No, don't point it at me either!
Ah! No, boys! It's a dragon! 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 Charge! This must be it. He must be in the cave. Right, charge! When I say charge, you charge. Charge!
It's a dragon! It's a dragon!
Going to offer her a nice cup of tea, and she just wandered off very quickly. Oh dear, where was I anyway? Oh yes, my personal recipe for seed cake. Now, what am I?
Aha! There you are at last. And hand her, you loathsome beast.
Hang on, is he talking about me?
George, stop it. You don't understand.
No. Come on, you coward. Fight!
think, sir. It seems to be blocked.
Well, unblock it then, quickly.
Poppy, stop it. George, stop it. Just listen to me.
Step aside, Hyacinth. I'll run him through. Oh,
George, I'm getting very crossy. Put that down. You calm down and you listen to me.
Maidens with PG tips. We can't have custard creams with PG tips.
No, that's just an awful story put about by Baron Blackheart.
So, you mean he won't burn all the houses, the crops, and the people to cinders?
No, Dudley is very cultured and polite.
Well, very glad to hear it. And I'm so glad you're safe.
Say your prayers, Dragon!
What's that thing he's pointing at me? Look, it's very rude to point. That's not nice.
You be careful, Dudley. That's a gun. They're the very latest thing, you know. Very dangerous.
Oh, yes, they are, as you're about to find out.
Bring Dudley, run!
Ah, Bermies! Get him away!
Hey, ho! Poor Dudley! We must save him!
Terrible cramp in my scales. Mm. Oh, but don't unfreeze him. He was going to blow my brains out.
Well, he's got every right to. If you will go around eating maidens, people will fight back.
Not this again. Look, I said it till I'm green in the face. Look, ask the boys and girls if green dragons eat maidens.
All right, I will. Boys and girls, do green dragons eat maidens?
No! Sitting maidens to you for all these years, then?
No, don't ask me. That's all to do with him. You better ask him.
I will.
Oh, but don't freeze him. He's got nasty guns.
Oh, I'll soon render that thing harmless. Now my old one's working so well. Yes. Now you stick of flame and war, frighten this poor dragon no longer.
Is that you, brother dear?
Could you?
Ah.
safe and sound. But what about poor Noddy? Has he given his all?
No.
Oh, Noddy, it's like a dream come true. I'm so happy I could just burst into song. I could sing and sing and sing.
Oh, but Queen Bee, we've got so much to tell you.
Oh, well, there's plenty of time for that when we get to the wedding.
Yes.
I just want to sing. I just want to sing my heart out. You'll help me, won't you?
We'd love to, but we've got a lot of preparations to make for the wedding.
What about you?
Me? Oh, well, you see, I would, but I'm just so exhausted, you know, from all the running about. I'm just going to have a bit of a lie down.
Noddy, you've stayed to sing with Queen Bee, haven't you?
No.
What a rotten lot. Still, never mind. You'll help me sing a song, won't you?
Yeah. Yes!
You know why I'm going to sing this song, don't you?
No.
You think it's because I'm so happy. Well, it's not. It's so they can change their costumes ready for the wedding. Fair, you know. I've got to get changed as well. Right. Oh, I've got some helpers who have stayed. My loyal men. Well done. Well done for standing by me. So we'll all sing a song. It's a very well-known song. You all know it. It's called My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. And there are a lot of bees in My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. And there's a movement to each bee. So we want you to do the movement. So it starts, my bonnie lies over the ocean, my bonnie lies over the sea, my bonnie lies over the ocean, so bring back my bonnie to me. So you get the drift, don't you? So we're doing it with some music, I think. And these guys will all help you. So Sir Pete, could we have the music, please?
My bonnie lies over.
Do it faster?
Yeah.
Yes. Can we do it faster, Sabine? Right, we'll do it faster.
My body lies over the ocean. My body lies over the sea. My body lies over the ocean. So bring back my body to me. Bring back, bring back. Oh, bring back my body to me.
So Pete, can we do it even faster, please?
My body lies over the ocean. My body lies over the sea. My body lies over the ocean. So bring back my body to me. Bring back, oh, bring back my body to me, to me. Bring back, oh, bring back my body to me.
Pantomimes, it's all turned out quite well, except for Baron Blackheart, who's still under Muddle's spell. That useless wand with a useless fairy has borne a heavy load, and Baron Blackheart still remains a slimy, nasty toad.
Thanks again.
very nice, that thing.
Oh, perhaps you're right.
And now the upstanding for the newly appointed Knight of the Stirrup Pump, Counselor of the Privy and Defender.
Do get a move on.
Lord Hortby.
Greetings, peasants and commoners. Well, it's good to see nobility's not changed you anyway. Ah, how true. I am still the old lovable Hortby.
But why have you been made Lord Hortby?
You did nothing, you
should. Even Queen Bee's idea was better.
It was Fairy Muddle that sorted it all out.
Oh, I don't want any thanks, dear. I aim to please, and it was just all in a day's work.
Well, I don't think Baron Blackheart would quite agree with that. He's still a toad, although, admittedly, he has changed colour daily, and for a brief period, he was a newt.
But Warren Baron Blackheart was filling his
own. Oh, surely nobody deserves to be a toad.
Or a newt. What's worse is that Bessie and Bertha haven't stopped bawling since. Excuse me, I think a hasty departure is in order.
Oh, Hortby! Our brother's still a toad!
Fairy Muddle, do something, they're soaking my new clothes!
I suppose I could try. Thunders roar, torrential rain, change the baron back up.
Excuse me, Fairy Muddle, if we may interrupt.
I think what we've noticed is that when your spells go wrong, it's that... delicately.
You're a rotten rhymer.
How dare you?
Thank you, I went
to the Pamers School of Poetry.
Well, yes, I can believe that, but this time, without the aid of your magic wand,
could we hear
the spell first?
Very well. Thunders roar, torrential rain, change the baron back once more.
Oh, no, that don't sound quite right.
No, I think the rhyme should end with again.
Change the baron back once more again?
No, no, we don't need once more again, do we?
No.
All together now.
Thunders roar, torrential rain, change the baron back again!
Oh, what's happening?
Oh, Hortby, you did it!
A hero!
What have I done?
Oh, that's it. You all have fun. Don't worry about me. I've been around, feeling sick.
Oh, dear brother, why do you feel sick?
I think I'm eating worms. And I'm eating flies as well. Oh, especially those blue bottles.
Well, that's gratitude for you.
Yeah, typical. It took us ages to catch all those.
Yes. There, Baron, don't you worry. You were just following on from your father and your grandfather before.
You know, you're right. I just... misunderstood. I was only trying to find myself a wife.
Oh, stop snivelling.
Don't be so nasty, Hortby. You might be a lord. He's a baron.
You're very understanding, you know. I've had a terrible life.
Oh, that sounds awful. Tell me about it.
Oh, when I was born, my mother took one look at me and locked herself in the cupboard for 4 years.
Oh, that's awful. Then what happened?
Well, then she came out and looked at me and threw herself
on the chin. You know, I've had an awful life too, Orby. It's so sad.
Nowhere near as bad as mine.
You were cosseted, you were. I didn't even have a dress to wear. I used to have to wear an old sack. A sack? You had a sack? I didn't have a dress. I used to paint a brook on me. Send me to bed at 6 o'clock. A bed? You had a bed? I didn't have a bed, I just had a bit of straw down on the floor in me room.
Room? You had a room? I didn't have a room, I had a cupboard.
Well, when I say a room, I mean I had a bit of mud down in the garden where the straw went.
You had a garden?
Their Royal Majesties, Queen Beatrice and King Nodford.
You don't get this in Primark, you know. Designed by Vera Wang, from fabric woven by silkworms, for a figure by...
Michelin!
Who said that? Did you hear that nod?
No.
Is that all you're ever going to say?
No,
it isn't, is it? Because today you've got to say something different, haven't you?
No.
Oh, yes, you have. when the Archbishop says, do you give your royal permission for these two young people to be married? What are you going to say then?
Yes!
Yay!
When there's no one there to catch your fall.